The Philippines and Australia highlighting maritime cooperation during a conference ahead of the special ASEAN summit. Australia's top diplomat Penny Wong says Canberra is committed to supporting ASEAN's leadership in ensuring peace in the region. She also announced a $64 million Australian dollar funding to help boost maritime security among Southeast Asian nations. As for the Philippines, it vows to uphold diplomacy over the use of threat or force in handling maritime issues.
The South China Sea holds an even more promising future as a hub where blue economies could emerge, reminiscent of the pulsating maritime trade that historically connected the peoples of the region with each other and with nature. We pursue and honor mutually beneficial arrangements, including with Australia, as part of our duty to strengthen the rules-based security architecture and preserve regional and global peace, security, and stability.
The Philippine Coast Guard has deployed a vessel to make that resource-rich Philippine Rise, formerly known as Benam Rise, amid the reported presence of Chinese ships there. The BRP Gabriela Silang will patrol the vicinity of both the Philippine Rise and the province of Batanes for 2 weeks. Two Chinese research vessels were recently seen loitering near Philippine Rise. It was only on Saturday that they left the country's exclusive economic zone. The Philippine Navy downplaying the latest intrusion of Chinese ships on Philippine waters.
Okay. I believe it is just a normal transit passage. It is not a cause of concern kasi based on UNCLOS authorized naman dumaan sa exclusive economic zone ng isang coastal state. Ang maritime traffic.
Larger than Luzon, the Philippine Rise is significant due to its rich biodiversity and potential mineral and natural gas deposits. Beijing firing back at a top Philippine envoy over his claims on the South China Sea dispute. Philippine Ambassador to the U.S. Jose Manuel Romualdez earlier said tensions between Manila and Beijing are more alarming than the possibility of an escalated dispute between China and Taiwan. He also accused Beijing of using economic coercion against Manila. The Chinese embassy slams Romualdez, saying he only used the maritime dispute to launch a malicious smear campaign against Beijing. It also urged the ambassador, whom it called a mouthpiece of the U.S., to stop spreading xenophobia or anti-Chinese remarks. An analyst says while the Philippines cannot expect much from ASEAN when it comes to maritime issues, the president should continue to use it as a forum to take a stand against China. Renato De Castro says even if the principle of unanimity prevents the bloc from taking decisive actions, it should not stop President Marcos from convincing other nations to side with the Philippines.
The game plan also of the president in terms of when he called the new paradigm in approaching the West Philippine Sea, South China Sea issue, is that we could, at least within ASEAN, have a small coalition of the willing. Probably you can have some maritime Southeast Asian countries joining the Philippines in, of course, at least resolving their overlapping claims in the South China Sea, and of course, one way or the other, having some understanding on how they would deal with the elephant in the room. That is, of course, Chinese expansive maritime expansion in the South China Sea.
A public policy think tank sounds the alarm over what it calls a pest crisis in Manila's main gateway. InfraWatch PH says the viral videos of bedbugs, cockroaches, and a rat at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport are bad for the country's tourism sector. The group says airport authorities should be held accountable for such incidents.
There is already what we can call a pest crisis in the Ninoy Aquino International Airport, and no amount of excuses being given by the MIAA and the Department of Transportation will essentially uplift the view of the public that there is a grave maintenance problem in the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. We have to sincerely apologize, not just to the public, but also to the international community for essentially national humiliation. It is very difficult to simply lay blame on maintenance operators or pest control operators, pest control contractors. But ultimately, there ought to be a question on whether or not MIAA officials can actually run this particular airport. Well, from today up until the last day in which before there's a transfer to the private sector.
Well, the Manila International Airport Authority admitting lapses in how they manage NAIA's sanitation. It's now considering canceling the contracts of its cleaning service providers.
Nire-review na namin ngayon ang contract. Inabutan ko yan. Sorry. Ayoko naman magbintang. Alam mo, napapagbayaan namin, tignan na maigi yung mga ginagamit yun ng chemical, kung talagang very thorough ba sila sa kanilang kontrata. Pangalawa, damay na ito yung pagkolekta ng mga basura. Ngayong hapon, mimitingin ko ulit yung mga apat na nangungontrata ng pest control dyan. Kung may violation yan, asensyahan na lang, i-revoke ko yan.
The territorial row between the cities of Makati and Taguig, well, that continues. This time, the local government of Taguig ordered the temporary closure of the Makati Park and Garden for allegedly operating without necessary permits. Taguig says it has the power to close the park since it is now under its jurisdiction, citing a Supreme Court ruling. As for Makati, it asserts having jurisdiction does not automatically mean Taguig has ownership over the disputed park. It also calls Taguig a bully. Makati employees had been trapped inside the park after Taguig padlocked its gate. Some members of the volunteer group Defend Makati have also camped outside the park to protest its closure. The country's three power giants, Meralco Power Gen, Aboitiz Power, and San Miguel Global Power, forge a $3.3 billion or 185 billion peso deal to jointly launch the Philippines' first and most expansive liquefied natural gas facility. Under the deal, MGEN and Aboitiz Power will invest in two of San Miguel's gas-fired power plants. These are the Ilihan Power Plant and a new 1,320-megawatt power facility, which is expected to start operations by the end of 2024. The three will then acquire nearly 100% of the LNG import and regasification terminal owned by Linseed Field Corporation. This will be used to receive, store, and process LNG fuel for the two power plants, fully integrating the local energy sector into the global natural gas supply chain. The Philippine Energy Department allays concerns over the power woes on Panay Island. This after three units of the province's power provider, PEDC, once again shut down last Friday, leading to a partial blackout. Power was fully restored this past Saturday. The DOE says residents of Panay Island may see some relief in the coming weeks. This is because the Cebu-Negros-Panay transmission link is expected to be completed by the end of the month. Meanwhile, the regular maintenance of one of the grid's large coal power plants, the PCPC, will also be finished during that time. Mixed movement in oil prices set this week. Gasoline prices will go up by 50 centavos per liter, while a liter of kerosene and diesel set to be cheaper by 35 to 40 centavos. The Philippine Energy Department earlier said higher crude supply in the U.S. and a possible ceasefire in the Gaza war led to lower diesel and kerosene prices. Meanwhile, tensions in the Red Sea driving up the price of cooking gas. Last Friday, LPG prices went up by 27 to 50 centavos per kilo.